Well, guys, we're gonna get this monster Cabazon cleaned out and this Lingcod. It's the first time I've ever cleaned a Cabazon out. So we're gonna do this together. I'm really thinking about where to start, because he said right here, right along the spine. Well, I'm probably just gonna be sliding all the time, which I don't want. He said right there.
Yeah, like just above the gill plate there, like that?
Yeah, because all the meat's right, you can feel the lateral line right here. You can really, ooh, you can see it. So I just gotta stay out of it.
Okay, you wanna watch from over here?
I can watch from right here. Or just right here.
Well, guys, the meat is blue. That's pretty cool. I'm pretty sure everybody watching this video right now can confirm that I've really bad at cleaning Cabazon. But, that's okay.
Pretty good chunk of meat in there.
No, don't pump yourself, bro.
See, the magic of camera editing is gonna make that look really, really smooth.
Just like whoosh, whoosh,
whoosh. Yeah. Oh, well, guys, that's gonna make some good fried fish or fish tacos. Meat's blue, so I don't know if you guys know how that tastes, but that's pretty cool. Well, guys, there's our Lingcod filet. This one has a bluish hue to it too, but not nearly as much as that Cabazon. So it's a nice one right there. Nice clean Ziploc bag. The knife we were given
blows.
Yeah, to say the least, it is the dullest knife I think my dad, me, and Nick have ever witnessed.
But enough to where you have to threaten your own safety to get meat off this thing.
Guys, you didn't see me in the video earlier. I had surgery on Tuesday. You know, I stepped wrong, messed up my ankle, got it fixed, long story short. But looks like the boys had a good trip. Got some Lingcod sitting around here somewhere. But we made some batter, some beer batter that is in the fridge right now.
That's our breading. I'll show you guys the beer batter.
This is the breading.
Yeah, you wanna let your beer batter try to rest for about a day. It makes it just a lighter texture once it's deep fried. So we got that going. We have a nice beer batter.
There's the Lingcod.
And then we have the Lingcod chilling. We already sliced it up, filleted it, got it deboned, and it is soon to be deep fried.
Yes.
Well, guys, Nick made it.
Just let the cribble handle the cast iron plane.
So, well, guys, we're heating our oil up to 360 degrees. We have the batter ready to go. It's been chilling for a night. And now we are going to dry off this fish. Make sure it's good to go. Dry fish makes it easier to season and easier to cook. Makes the batter stick and the breading. So we're gonna do that. Once all that's coated, we're gonna dip in the batter, fry it.
Pretty much, that's the gist at least.
Looks tasty.
Yeah, anyways, Duke's pretty excited, so. Guys, we're covering all those up with our seasoning. Really important to baste the oil on the fish, right, Nick?
Especially if it's not submerged, I guess. Yeah. According to Ramsey.
Mr. Ramsey. I hope he doesn't see this video.
He's not gonna see this video.
Alright. Could you imagine? He's like, what the f-?
Gordon comments on our video. Right,
we start our 2 minute timer for flip.
Well, guys, we're gonna make a nice tartar here. So, we don't have any sweet relish, but we do have pickles, so we're just gonna dice these suckers up, make them look nice. If you wanna help yourself out here, I know you're...
Dude, those pickles have been in there for a long time.
You can keep flipping them if you want. Guys, We're just gonna do, we have nothing. We are literally gonna do mayonnaise and mustard. And we're gonna see if that tastes good. Because we have nothing else. Worst case scenario, we use ketchup, but I might not go that low.
We're gonna go that low.
What the frick?
Well, guys, right now we are just dicing up these pickles to put in. I use half a whole pickle. Dicing them up into like shallot sized pieces here with a butter knife. Don't come at me. It's okay.
That is sad to watch.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly.
So everything's kind of sliced up. You put that in there. I don't have a spoon, but you want to just get a nice even coating on all that. Your pickle sizes can differ. No, I thought you like your pickles. Well, guys, the Lingcod looks good.
It does look good.
It looks good. Our hardware's ready to go here. We just salted them a bit. We're gonna let them rest for, you know, a minute or two, and then we'll crack them open and see what they taste like.
Let us know down in the comments if we should open a Salmon Slayer's TV restaurant waterfront service.
Well, guys, that was Carter's first bite. Probably pretty hot.
It is good, though.
I almost grabbed the pickles to drink.
That's what the chorus
Nick
is for.
Nick puts ketchup on.
Nick, what that's a sin.
What do you think?
Ketchup?
I think it's good. Let's try some. Let's not try this. Try the tartar. That's good.
Well, guys, the tartar ended up being pretty good. We have two more left. As you can tell, they're freaking gorgeous. Guy, he's having pains.
Yeah. Or I'm throwing. I had to elevate the foot for a little bit before it burst.
I'm throwing.
Gordon Ramsay did not fail us, guys. This is a good recipe.
Okay, I will say the beer batter is actually super good, nice and flaky. And it's not like, you know, when you get fish and chips at like not a very nice restaurant, you get like that super thin, super like crusty.
Like it's see-through, you can see the fish through.
Yeah, it's not very good. This is actually high quality and it's pretty good.
We surprised ourselves. Anyways, we're gonna munch this, head out. Thanks for watching. As always,
tight lines.